Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I will show you how I created this office rendering in Revit. Let's get started. Go to New, Architecture Template, and press OK. I'm gonna hit UN for units. And then I'm going to change it to millimeters. Press OK. Let's create a wall. I'm going to edit type, duplicate. Let's call this wall 1. Let's create another one, wall 2, press OK. Let's put it at 1. Here for wall 2, I'm going to change it to a thicker size. Put 360, then I'm gonna keep on changing wall 2 and wall 1. So this will be the brick that I'm gonna change the materials later. Let's go to $1,800. Again, wall 2. $630. This is brick again, so wall 1. $1,800. Wall 2, 630 for the concrete pillar. And then let's close up the wall. I'm going to edit wall 1 now. I'm going to change this to brick. Sorry, I'm going to change that to, so I changed this to wall 3 and then wall 2 for the concrete. So wall 1's going to be just a painted white wall. Let's look for concrete. I'll choose this concrete precast. Apply and then OK. And then press OK. I selected the walls. That's going to be brick. Let's choose brick common for now. And lastly, wall one. I'm looking for something white. I'll choose the clad white first. Or maybe the gypsum wall board. Press OK. Let's create the floor. We need to lock it. Just in case we move the walls, it will follow. Edit type. I want to change this to a carpet. I'm going to put the section line facing the wall with different finishes. I'm just going to stretch the view. I notice that it's too tall. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all walls and connect them to level 2. Here you can select one and then you can press tab and it will select everything. For some reason I forgot about that. So top constraint level 2 and then apply. I'm gonna add a curtain wall. So in between the bricks, there's gonna be a window. So I'm gonna use a curtain wall. I'm gonna offset the base, offset it by 1500. Hit apply. So let's go back to section. We need to cut the solid brick and then we need to cut the window, so the glazing. This one looks good. Let's check our floor plan. I'm gonna create a 3D view. I'm setting up my image for the rendering. I noticed the brick is too high. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change that to probably 1000, depending on the look. So I'm gonna go back and forth. So I select the brick. I'm just checking the look now. A different display. I can either do this here or into my properties. So I just change it into my properties. So I tried 1000, then press apply. In this point, it looks good. Or 800 might be better. Okay, so 800 is much better. I'll change all of them to 800. So this one, I like it better. So next thing is, I'm gonna load all of this Revit family that I created, except for the decorations. I created the chair, the tables. So once it loaded, you go to your components and then just drag in and drop. Hit spacebar if you want to change the orientation. Let's fast forward here so that you don't need to wait for me to fix all of them. putting the lateral cabinet. Putting the office phone, a tower, and then now all the decorations. There's a binder. I'm gonna put the ceiling up there. I'm gonna load some families, light families. I'm going to choose a linear box. I'm just going to add this. Let's see it on 3D view. I don't like that I'm seeing the light, so I'm gonna cut that, or I'm gonna change it from the ceiling plan and move it to the right. And then now I'm fixing all the decorations. That's the phone, ink holder, and that's the globe that I just put. Fix the orientation of the chair as well. I'm going to change the camera, or I'm going to create a new camera view. press RR and then you can do the rendering. And after that, you can adjust the exposure. So you can play around with exposure value, highlight, shadows, saturation. Thank you for watching and I hope you liked the video. Please hit like and subscribe and feel free to comment down below.